Hi there. I'm doing a reading of the Iliad. Luckily, this intro should be quick because the plot of the Iliad is simple. King Agamemnon of Mycenae has rounded up as many Greeks as he could and brought them to Troy in modern-day Western Turkey in an effort to take the city and get vengeance for his brother, Menelaus, whose wife was maybe or maybe not kidnapped by a Trojan nobleman. But the story of the Iliad itself begins in medias res, which is to say, in the middle of things. The poem only covers around 50 days in the ninth year of a 10-year war. It tells the story of, you could say, the turning point in that war, when any hope the Trojans have of fending the Greeks off is lost with the death of their greatest warrior, Hector. Now, Homer's vision of Bronze Age Greece was very important to the Iron Age Greeks. It filled many cultural roles. You could almost see it like part Bible, part Shakespeare. Like, for example, Alexander the Great, when he went to conquer the world, as he knew it, supposedly slept with a copy of the Iliad under his pillow. And those are the people he was trying to emulate, and who he thought were his ancestors. The values and the deeds that were portrayed were profound and lasting, and the way they were told in was poignant. So much so that even to this day, you know, 3,000 years, more than 3,000 years after the events that this poem is talking about have passed, we still know who Achilles is. We know the significance of his heel. People know Troy burned. You know, a multi-million-dollar movie can still be sold based on this tale. You know, we still use expressions and adages from this time. We still say give up the ghost or bite the dust. We still pour one out for our homies, you know. We still say grace and all the virtues that this poem reverences. In short, the Iliad matters, culturally, for the West at least. And we owe that profundity to the blind poet Homer, whether or not he actually existed. He left us a great work that has been important. But we don't hold the expectation that his work is history. It's not a chronicle. He has poetic license. And you know, there's lots of hints in the text itself that it was written from a later period. The ships he describes do not come from that period. The use of iron tools didn't obviously happen in the Bronze Age, but there is truth in there. We have archaeological evidence for the existence of Agamemnon, and we think even Paris. But the story has built up over time, you know, the way stories do. They get better and better. They get more dramatic and more dramatic. So there's a nugget of truth in the Iliad, but legend has built up over it. So don't expect this to be, so don't expect history here. This is legend. Now, I need help, I'm not gonna lie. I frankly don't know what I'm doing. But I feel like this is a story I need to hear, and if you feel the same way, please let me know and shoot me a message with however you want to collaborate. Now, if you're curious, I'm using the Penguin translation of the Iliad by the author Evie Ryu. Now, this means you'll hear the Greek names for the gods, so it'll be Zeus instead of Jupiter, which I'm happy with. I think the Roman names for the gods sound silly in a Greek poem. But now, without further ado, I present you Book 1 of the Iliad by Homer.